Oklahoma, Karen Ledbetter, good morning, Pauline from the UK, hallelujah, I saw you pop up there, good morning from the Smokies, that's where I am, praise God, Japanese is not my strong suit. I travel so many places, sometimes I cannot remember where I am on any given day. Sweden, South Africa, Bermuda, good morning, Charlotte, hello, Angel Morano. Karakatam Rishtikiti. Tasmania, good morning. Ireland, good morning. Buffalo, Philadelphia. Prophet Jamila, good morning. Radical Friday, I like it. What do you see? What do you see? I need a bunch of seers around me that can tell me all the time what they see. PrayForJennifer.com. I want your prophetic insights. I want people who know how to pray and hear from God and share with me. What God is saying, share with me what you're seeing. Good morning, Pastor Mitch. Pigeon Forge, yes. I'm in Pigeon Forge now. That's where I am. You're so smart. Good morning, Sandra. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Getting aggravated. Let's pray for them. Praise God. Good morning, John Broderick. South Dakota, good morning. Listen, share this with your friends. Invite your followers. We got to get started. Invite your friends. Share this with your followers. Got to get started. Jacksonville, good morning. Bahamas, California. Good morning, South Africa. Let's get started. Share, invite, share, invite. We're going for it. Amen. Jennifer LeClaire here with you, author of our devotional Mornings with the Holy Spirit, listening daily to the still small voice of God, senior leader of the Awakening House of Prayer, founder of the Ignite Network. God is good. All the time. I had such a dream last night. I might share that with you later. Some dreams are disturbing, you know. Some dreams are edifying. Some dreams are warning dreams. There's all kinds of dreams, you know. I might share about that later. Today's devotional titled, Yield to Me in the Wilderness. Yield to Me in the Wilderness. And here's what I heard the Lord say. When you find yourself in a wilderness place, it's possible that I led you there to show you something about yourself. Or it's possible that you stumbled off my perfect path into a place of trial and temptation. You will discern the reason for the season when you stop fighting it and start yielding to me, says God. I will show you what you need to see and tell you why you're in the wilderness if you need to know. Catch that, if you need to know. I assure you that I will lead you out at the right time. Yield to me, learn from me. Praise God. That's a good word. I don't care where you're from. Today's scripture references Hebrews 2 and 18, Hebrews 12, verse 11, and Proverbs chapter 12, verse 1. And the prayer starter for today, I don't like being in a wilderness place, but I understand that you have a purpose for every season. When I find myself in the desert, please help me to remember your words. Help me to learn quickly what you're trying to teach me. Amen. Praise God. Father, we thank you this morning for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. You are the one true and living God. We met Jesus. You are worthy of our praise. You are worthy. You are more worthy than words can express. But we lift up our words. We lift up our hearts to you, God. We love you with an imperfect love because our love is not perfect the way your love is. But you accept, receive, and enjoy expressions of our love. So we lavish our love upon you this morning, God. You are magnificent and holy. You are a beautiful God. You are a beautiful Savior. There is just no one who can compare to you. Oh, nothing is worthy to be compared to the one true and living God, the God that saved us, the God that healed us, the God that snatched us from the pit of hell, the God that holds us in his hand and nothing shall by any means harm us. We thank you that you are our protector. You are protector, God. You are provider, God. You are healer, God. You are an encouraging God. You speak words of life to us. Oh, the enemy wants to speak words of death, but you speak words of life. The enemy wants to tell us who we are and pervert that which you've called us to do. You want to give us purpose. The enemy wants to pervert, and you want to give purpose. We thank you, Lord. We will not see ourselves as less than. We will not see ourselves through the eyes of the enemy. We will not see ourselves through that wicked lens that he tries to put in front of us, that mirror, that perversion, that mirror of perversion that makes us seem less than, not good enough, whatever it is he's tried to. Okay, Lord, what do you see? The Lord's asking you, what do you see? What do you see about yourself? What do you see about yourself? What do you see about yourself? The Lord says, I see you through the blood of Jesus. I see you as in my Son. But the enemy comes to bring condemnation to your doorstep. He comes with shame and guilt and accusations from your past that are not even true. They never were true. Things about you that other people have believed because the enemy told them, they're not even true. They never were true. But I see you in my Son. I see you as ready to run. I see you as victorious. I see you on top of the mountain. I see you doing a victory lap. I see you going around and around and around and defeating every single enemy that would try to oppose you because I've given you my name and I've given you my blood. I've given you my authority. So stop seeing yourself as less than. I see you as healed, says God. I see you healed in your body. I see you healed in your mind. I see you healed in relationships. I see you walking in divine health. What do you see, says God? What do you see? What do you see? What do you see? I want you to begin seeing things the way that I see them, says the Lord. See things through my eyes. See things through the lens of faith. See things through the eyes of Scripture. See things the way that I do. Stop allowing the enemy to paint you with a brush from the past. Stop allowing the enemy to paint you with a brush of shame, with a brush of fear, with a brush of rejection, because you are my masterpiece, says the Lord. You are my masterpiece. I created you for good works. You are my masterpiece. You are perfect in my eyes because I see you through the blood of Jesus. And yes, I know that you have faults and I know that you have shortcomings and I know that you don't always measure up to the fullness of the stature of my Son yet. But you will, says God, you will, because I'm changing you from glory to glory. And in the meantime, I see you for who I've called you to be instead of seeing you for who you're not. Oh, what do you see, says God? What do you see? What do you see? What do you see? Look at yourself in the mirror of my word. My word is a mirror. It reflects the image of Christ. Look at yourself as in him, and you will become more like him. Look at yourself as in him, says God, and you will become more like him. When you see yourself as you really are in Christ, you will morph into that image. You will become that little by little, from faith to faith, from strength to strength, from glory to glory, you will become that. But when you see yourself as the devil wants you to see yourself, when you buy into the lie, says God, when you buy into the perverted picture he paints for you, says God, when you buy into that, I see a book of lies, my God. Ah, shakatam brishte, kubrashte shikite. I see a book of lies. My God, you know, the Bible says that God has all your days are written in the book. There's a book of life. And he's got another book that all your days are written in. He's got a book of life. And your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. Isn't that what the Bible says? Your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. But the enemy, he's got a book of lies. He's got a book of lies. He's got a book of lies. And he tries the same lies out on all of us, waiting to see who will fall for us. Waiting to see who will fall for it. Waiting to see who will take the bait. He's got a book of lies. He doesn't have anything new to offer. His lies are the same old lies that he's been lying, that he lied to Eve with. It's the same old thing. Did God say that? Did God say that? Did God say that? Did God say that? He's an accuser. Of God. He accuses God to us. He accuses you to God. He accuses you to other people. He accuses other people to you. He is the accuser of the brethren, and he has a book of lies. His playbook is just a book of lies. That's all he's got. Lies, lies, lies. He is the father of lies. He is the father of lies. He's the father of lies. That's all he's got. That's the only weapon he has against you is lies, 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 lies. He's got a book of lies. Dear God, I thank you, Lord, that your book of life is greater than the enemy's book of lies, that your book of life in which our names are written secures us eternity. It secures us everlasting life. It secures us a spot with you forever, the right to come boldly to the throne of grace in this age. It secures us healing. It secures us everything that your covenant promises. It's security. It's assurance. It's security. It's assurance. I thank you, Lord. We're gonna blot out the lies of the enemy. We're gonna blot out the lies. We're going to blot them out. We're not believing them anymore. We're not listening to them anymore. We're not going to listen to a lie. Come on. What do you see? And I might ask you today, what do you hear? Because what you hear affects what you see and affects what you say. Come on. What you hear affects what you see and what you say. I'm going to say it again. What you hear affects what you see and what you say. Because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. And all of your thoughts, that's what you're hearing. That's what you're hearing. And the vain imaginations, that's what you're hearing. There are many voices in the spirit and none without significance. What do you hear? 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 What are you listening to? What are you thinking about? What do you see? It depends on what you hear. Oh God, would you help us, God, to assimilate your thoughts. Your thoughts are higher than our thoughts. Your ways are higher than our ways. Oh, but God, we can attain to your thoughts. You're thinking about us all the time. You're thinking about us every moment. You're thinking about us day and night, night and day, in the middle of the day, in the middle of the night. You're thinking about us, and your thoughts towards us, they're good. Your thoughts towards us, they're truthful. Your thoughts towards us are to give us a future and a hope. And the enemy's thoughts for us are evil. Oh, they're evil. They're evil and they're wicked. And we're not going to listen any longer. We're not going to look any longer. We're not going to listen and we're not going to look. We're not going to listen to the enemy, and we're not going to look at what he wants us to look at. Oh God, we thank you. Direct our eyes to the throne. Direct our hearts to the throne. Direct our mouths to the throne. Let us glorify your name this morning and break through all enemy oppression. Let us glorify you, God. Let us glorify you, God, with our lips, with our thoughts, with our actions, with everything in us, God. Let us glorify you. Let us not be those who glorify the devil with all of our complaining. And oh, woe is me. Oh, I'm so sorry and pitiful. Oh, the devil's messing with me. Oh, the devil's just got me in a corner. Oh, the devil's attacking. Lord, let us stop that. Help us to stop it in the name of the Lord. Help us to be those who glorify you with our lips and not the enemy's plans in our lives. We're going to speak forth your plans. We're going to speak forth your will. We're going to speak forth your glorious nature. We're going to speak forth that which you put in our mouth. God, put a new word in our mouth and a new song in our heart. Put a new word in our mouth and a new song in our heart. God, would you help us today to get it right? To get our vision right. To get our vision right. Oh, the Lord shows me there's some seers out there, and your vision has been skewed through a season of warfare. Ah, shakatarokoto. There's some seers out there, and your vision has been skewed during a season of warfare. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? I want to pray for your vision. It has been skewed by a season of spiritual warfare. It's like you've begun to see things not as they are, but as the enemy wants you to see them. It's like, it's it's like, you know what? Here's what you got to do. It's you. Here's what you got to do. Listen to me now. Whatever the enemy is showing you, just look around the corner, because that's where something better lies. Just look around the corner. See, when you're a seer, you can choose what you look at. Yes, you can. Listen, you can choose what you look at. You don't have to continue looking at what the enemy wants you to see. It's one thing. I'm pray teaching you now. Come on, seers. It's one thing to see. It's one thing to see what the enemy is doing. It's another thing to sit there and be mesmerized by it. Come on. If you're going to look and see what the enemy's doing, look in the spirit and see what God wants to do. Look in the spirit and see the other side of what God has planned. Come on. Don't just only see the bad stuff. Some seers, I've met some of you, and you're precious, but all you ever see is devils, devils, devils. Come on. There's a God in there somewhere. He's in there somewhere. He's in there somewhere. God's blessings, God's angels, God's Holy Spirit, they're in there somewhere. If you're going to press in and you're going to see the demons and the warnings, press through and see the solution and see the Lord. Hallelujah. But some of you have been just mesmerized by things the enemy is showing you because it's so vivid. It's so almost overwhelming visually. You've been mesmerized by it. But the Lord says, take a glimpse, but don't keep staring. Take a glimpse, but don't keep staring. Take a glimpse. Get the information that I'm allowing you to see in the spirit. Get the information. Get the details, but don't let it mesmerize you. Don't let it throw you off course. Don't let it cause you to stumble. Don't let it bring fear in your heart. Oh, just take a glimpse. Write down the details, but then look for me, says God, because I will show you things to come, not just things the enemy is doing, but things that I want to do. Hallelujah. Come on. Don't dwell there, seers. Don't dwell there, seers. Don't dwell there, seers. Don't dwell there, seers. See what God wants you to see. See it all. See both sides of it. Come on. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. Seers, some of your eyes have been polluted by things the enemy showed you in your dream. You couldn't even choose it. You couldn't decide it because it was in your dream. The Lord is healing your eyes. Some of you don't even want to dream anymore, because of the things you see in the nighttime. They're not pleasant, but the Lord is healing your eyes. And I thank you, Jesus. I release God dreams, not just the demonic dreams, not just the warning dreams, but the seer anointing, God, includes all of it. So, Lord, bring the fullness of the expression of the seer to your seers, God. Lord, those who have been weighed down on just the glory side, Lord, let them also see what the enemy is doing. Bring balance to the seer anointing, God. I thank you, Lord. Even though we predominantly have a gift, as sometimes people do, they are bent more towards seeing just glory things. Some seers are more bent towards seeing just what the devil's doing, but there needs to be some kind of balance. We don't need to just hang in the glory and never see what the devil's doing, and we don't just need to see what the devil's doing and never see the glory. So, Lord, bring balance to our seer anointing, God, in Jesus' name. Bring balance, Lord. Bring balance, Lord. Bring balance, Lord. Bring the balance that you want, not the balance we think we need, but the balance that you want. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus, because you're good. You are good. You are good. You are good. That just reminded me of something. Hallelujah. Okay, what do you see? 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 Thank you, Lord. What do you see? Hallelujah. Oh, shura mashti kitim. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. O shorra mashti shiki tim brashta kataravashti. Shoko toroboshti kitirivishti. Some of the seer's eyes need to be healed. And others of you need that seer anointing. Praise God. You don't have to be a seer to be able to see in the spirit. Hallelujah. Praise God. This is what the Lord was showing me. I was praying all this. This just came out of my mouth. But the Lord showed me yesterday that that we're having a what do you see prophetic teaching theme at Awakening House of Prayer, and the Lord showed me on November the 18th to do a one-time seer's anointing and prophetic impartation teaching. So a teaching with an impartation service. So we're going to be doing that on, I thought it was November 18th. It looks like our web developer once again put the wrong date. He's a precious guy, but let me just double check the date. Seems like every time I give him a date, he puts the wrong date. Hallelujah. Either that or somebody on my staff gave him the wrong date. Amen. No, it's the right date. Praise God. We've had over and over people getting the wrong dates, and people all upset because they missed things, or they couldn't reconcile it on their calendar. So on November the 19th, activating the seer's anointing, a prophetic impartation. That's on ahop.tv. That is on ahop.tv. So if you want to watch that, go register at ahop.tv. Amen. Praise God. Okay. I want to pray one more time for the seers. But I want to remind you of that because I didn't know if it was up yet. And the Lord told me, because our theme this month is what do you see? And I thought, my goodness, I should have a special Sears meeting. And so if that's you, you want to get in on that. Some of you need a reactivation in your seeing. Some of you used to see and you don't see anymore. And that's because sometimes you saw some things you didn't want to see. And therefore, you almost shut your own anointing down. You just chose not to operate it. You didn't want it. And so God in his mercy will not allow you to be tormented by your own gift. Many times, if you just want to lay something down for a season, he'll let you do that if that's good for your own spiritual health. Amen. He's merciful. Some of you, it's time to pick up your seers. Look, I need seers all around me. King David, listen. King David had seers. He had seers. He had Gad and he had Nathan. He had Samuel. He had seers in his camp. I like seers. Praise God. Some people don't like seers. You know, they don't like them. Seers are, it's a kind of a prophet, okay? It's a kind of prophet. Not all prophets are seers, but all seers are prophets, okay? Somebody Facebooked me the other day about that, and their name was Prophetic Seer something. I didn't answer because I was on the road, but that's the short answer. Amen. So if you want to be part of that, go to ahop.tv and register for that. But I want to pray one more time for the seers. And I also have something else I want to share with you about false accusations from the past. I had a dream, and I haven't processed it yet, but I got enough of it to know what the enemy is doing in this season with a lot of people, and so I'm going to release that in a moment. But I want to pray for the seers again. Father, I thank you for the seers. I thank you, Lord, that you raise them up to the positions and the posts that you've called them to in this hour. That you, God, would help them, Lord, to stand and withstand against the onslaught that comes against their mind, even in their dreams, in Jesus' name. God, help them, Lord, to walk worthy of the vocation to which you've called them. Not to be unappreciated, God, but help the people around them to appreciate their gift. Yeah, the Lord shows me many of you seers. The reason why you stopped expressing your gift is because people didn't appreciate it. People actually persecuted you for it. They didn't like what you were seeing. And so, Father, I thank you that you bring healing to the seers in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Listen, I would like to give you the opportunity to sow. You know that I always do that. I travel to the nations. I do a lot of things like the Awakening Blaze prayer movement and different initiatives that the Lord has called as the TV initiative, and a lot of social media groups that we actually have erected so that we can minister to people around the world through, angels and different things like that. And so all this requires funding, all this requires resources, human resources, financial resources. So I'm giving you an opportunity to sow. Listen, some of you need to just listen to the Lord. Some of you need to find out before 2000. Listen, I'm giving you a strategy now. Before beginning of 2018, all of you, myself included, all of you need to come up with a giving strategy for 2018. Now, you must be led by the Lord. You must be led by the Lord, but some of you don't have a giving strategy. So I have a giving strategy. Why? Because I want a consistent harvest, and I want a harvest that never stops flowing. Therefore, I have a giving strategy. About this time every year, around between November and December, is when I sow very large seeds. Why? I'm preparing myself for the next year, but I also have a giving strategy. As a house of prayer, we sow into Israel. My ministry sows into a feeding program. So there's a very specific giving strategy that we've developed. Some of you need to do that for 2000. Just sit down and think, what can I budget to give? Above and beyond my tithe and my offerings to my church, even if it's just a small amount, what can you budget to give and target that seed? Target that seed. Come up with a giving strategy. That's what I do. That's what I'd encourage you to do. Praise God. If you want to donate into this ministry to help forward the vision, you can do that at jenniferleclaire.org/donate. Yes, giving extravagantly as always. Listen, I want to sow so much in 2018 that I can't help but get an overblow harvest. I did that last year. I'm going to do it next year. But as a house of prayer, as our church, as a ministry, I've done this personally, but as a ministry, I'm going to sow so much in 2018 that there will be just a massive harvest. Amen. Praise God. All right. If you want to give it, sow a seed, you can do that. JenniferLeClaire.org/donate. You can do a one-time seed there, or you can do a partnership there. Unless you're international. And right now, internationals cannot, because we don't have it set up yet. But you can, internationals, you can sow a seed at paypal.me/JenniferLeClaire. paypal.me/JenniferLeClaire. You can do that. You can also use text to give, 754-701-2161. 751-751-2161. Text the word pray. P-R-A-Y. Text the word pray. P-R-A-Y, praise God. Now, if you want to use P.O. Box or send up a check or a money order, you can do P.O. Box 3953, Hallandale Beach, Florida, 33009. Amen. Praise God. God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Sow and you will grow. Sow somewhere. Don't be stingy. Sow somewhere. You should be sowing somewhere. Amen. Praise God. All right, listen, I want to share with you a few announcements. So you heard about the AHOP TV event with the Sears anointing. Praise God, you can get in on that. And what else do we have? I want to encourage you. Where are we? I've lost my spot. I want to encourage you to sign up for the prayer and mentoring and prayer and intercession program. These slots are filling up fast. I've not done much about this publicly. I think I put one Facebook post, and the only other place I've mentioned it is on Periscope and Facebook on these broadcasts that I do every day. So if you're wanting to get in on that, please don't hesitate. Go and get in on it now. You'll get, like, I think it's 5 free downloads. There's ebooks and different audios I've put together for you to bless you. Starting here next week, we're going to start sending out emails each week to the mentoring list to get you primed and ready to run on January the 3rd, so you can do that. Let me write that down. If you want to learn how to pray more effective prayers, if you want to learn how to dig into to deeper realms of intercession, if you want to learn how to pray for prodigals, if you want to learn all these different aspects of prayer, what tool to use when, if you want mentoring in spiritual warfare, all these kind of things, you're going to want to sign up for this mentoring program. You're going to go to schoolofthespirit.tv. At some point, I will share even more with you as we get closer, but right now, I'm not blasting it too much because I'm getting such a strong response, and I'm really feeling like you all are the hungry ones in the morning on my prayer call. So I will be starting to announce this publicly next week. I think I'm home all next week before I'm out then most of the rest of the month. So next week is going to be strategy week for me, and I will begin to blast this out to the body of Christ, and the spaces are going to fill, like, probably, they'll probably mostly fill up next week. So get in on this now if you want to get in on it. Amen. If you want to listen in on the Awakening Blaze Vision Call, the prayer movement Vision Call, back where I cast vision about what we're doing, that's Tuesday, November the 7th at 6 p.m. Wednesday, November 8th, Supernatural Shift, Unlocking Your Miracles. Listen, you're going to want to get in on this event with Larry Sparks teaching about miracles. I'll be there with him. We're going to be dialoguing and teaching you. That is November 8th at 7 p.m. If you cannot be on these calls, sign up if you want to hear them, because we'll send you the link. Amen. You can go to jenniferleclaire.eventbrite.com. JenniferLeClaire.eventbrite.com. You can go sign up. There's tons of different free events there that you can sign up for. But if you're going to want to do the Sears anointing thing, you're going to have to go to ahop.tv, all right? My Ignite Network, praise God, that is growing by leaps and bounds. We've activated over 400 prophetic voices this past year, and we're going strong into 2018 with some regional leaders. What is Ignite? It's a network of prophetic people who are contending to learn and grow together. You know, God wants a pure prophetic. God wants a pure prophetic. He doesn't want a perverted prophetic. And so you have the opportunity to align align with me at a loose level. There's also higher levels of alignment. We are actually restructuring the alignment right now. So please don't sign up for alignment and then come and say, you know, I want to be, I'm aligned. If you have to be accepted to be aligned. So there's some confusion there with that. It does say on the site, you know, please contact our office for more information. You're not supposed to just sign up for that without talking to us. We're restructuring that right now. So hopefully next week I will get to that. Next week I'll be filming several episodes of the new Jezebel, the new TV show, Your Prophetic Voice, and Jezebel, the Jezebel's episodes I'll be doing. And that reminds me, I've got to buy some more gear, some more lights. Amen. I'm writing that down. Amen. So listen, do what blesses you. Get involved with what blesses you. A lot of these phone calls you can sign up for. You don't have to necessarily listen to them live. I think it's great to listen to them live because many times we'll open it up for Q&A. But if you can't, get the recording if you want to listen to it. Listen to it on your car on the way to work then. Amen. Get registered. Let's see. What else do we have here? I'm sure I'm forgetting something, but I'm forgetting it. So if I'm forgetting it, I can't remember it. Praise God. I'm looking around here at what I'm supposed to say, and I cannot remember it. I'm in Pigeon Forge. I'll be teaching today on wisdom for the warfare. Wisdom for the warfare. Last night I blew it open, offended every religious spirit in Tennessee. Praise God. That's why they allow me to open on the conferences many times, is because I will go ahead and stir up all the religious devils. And when they leave and they don't come back the next day because they're offended, what happens is the atmosphere becomes even more powerful because you're not polluting it with all these religious negative Nancys and on downers, right? So praise God. I love it. We had a good time last night. I preached on the radical warrior, and it was powerful. It was good. God was there. It's always powerful when God's there, no matter who's teaching or what you're teaching. What matters the most is that God is there. Amen. Praise God. So come if you can to Pigeon Forge, and I'll be there tonight again. Apostle Ryan Lestrange will be preaching tonight, and I'll be there tomorrow. Then I'll go back home. Praise God. Start the What Do You See series. Hallelujah. Oh, our online campus. If you want to be part of our online campus, you can do that. This, again, I have not announced this. I'll probably be doing some announcements next week. AHOP.online. You want to be an e-member of our campus, or you want to be one that you want to be an e-member. When you register, you're registering as an e-member, and that allows you to get the prayer support and answer questions from our pastors and those sorts of things. So when you register there, you're an e-member, and you're able to tap into the benefits of e-membership, which are, you know, that being able to watch our broadcasts. They're no longer going to be on Facebook. You'll be able to watch our broadcasts. You'll be able to get prayer support and ask questions of pastors, and also be part of a community. You'll be able to leave comments there and talk to other people in the eCampus there in through the live stream. You'll be able to do that. So go register if you want to be an e-member. It doesn't mean that you're leaving your church, praise God. It just means that you are connecting with us. AHOP.online. Amen. Listen, I want to share it with you. I don't even remember all of this dream. I woke up mad. You know, your emotions in a dream can be very telling. Whenever you have a dream, you always want to write down or take a moment to discern what were your emotions in the dream. What were your emotions? And I woke up mad and irritated. I didn't stay that way because I knew it was just a dream. But I woke up mad and irritated, praise God. And in this dream, I just made a couple notes. I'd like to go back in it later. I was in a church that I used to go to. Isn't it in a church I used to go to a long time ago? And apparently I'd been in and out. I'd been traveling. Now, I didn't really travel when I was in that church, but I was in this church and I was traveling. And it's like I came back and everyone kind of had turned against me and had sort of taken over my part of the ministry there in the church. They had decided that I had abandoned the cause, and they'd sort of taken over. There's all these false accusations. I can't remember them all. And even people that you would have thought would have defended me from the accusations were not defending me. They kind of fell under that same spell and were just sort of... they were just sort of in that same vein, like really? The only one who did not turn against me was Karen. Praise God. Hallelujah. The only one in the dream, I couldn't see everybody in the dream, but the only one in the dream that didn't turn against me was Karen. Praise God. But it wasn't people from the past in the dream. It was people from the present. So I was in a place of a setting from the past, an old church that I left. I was in this old church, but the people in the church that were accusing me were people from the present. And it was very disturbing. I'm like, what are you even talking about? You know that I was traveling. You know that I was doing this. And they had taken over. They tried to take over my ministry in the church. Very strange. And so I came back and I was saying, here's this and here's that. And can't you see this and can't you see that? And then the police came and they were involved. And they had all these different banners from events. I guess they were events that I'd gone to, and they were investigating because I'd been to all these events, and here was the proof that I'd been to all these events, and one by one I explained it, and the police crossed it off, said okay, pop, 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 and they just dismissed all of it. And then finally people started coming around and understanding that they were wrong, and then all the accusations ceased and I was vindicated. But here's the thing, here's what the immediate thing I got out of this. And there's lots of layers here, but the immediate thing I got out of this is sometimes there's accusations from your past that come back to haunt you in your present, because the enemy uses the same thing over and over. He'll use the same accusation against you over and over. The same accusation that came against you at a church 10 years ago. Now, what's interesting is this is not an accusation that came against me ever, but this is what I got out of it when I woke up. Is it's because I haven't processed all of it yet, but there are accusations that people you had this accusation when you were a kid, then you had the accusation when you were a teenager, then you had an accusation in your marriage, then you had the accusation. It's like the same accusation over and over and over and over. And if you look back over your life, many of you will see that that's what the enemy has done. He's brought the same accusation over and over and over and over against you. And it's not true. It's all smoke and mirrors. But it's the same thing. So I want to break old accusations, because we're not going to allow the old accusations to come into the present. Amen? Hallelujah. Father, and I'm going to pray for vindication. Yeah. Amen. I'm going to pray for vindication for you as well. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus, Sakura. Sakura, you were not in the dream. Just so you know, you're clear. Praise God. Because I know you would have pounded that devil. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, Father, I thank you this morning. I thank you. I thank you, Lord, that we will not be bound to our past. Not accusations of the past, not sin of the past, not mistakes of the past. Hallelujah. We will not be bound to the past. We will not allow the enemy to wreak havoc on our lives in this season with an accusation from a past season. I break every old accusation against you. I break every accusation, past, present, and future. We break the lies of the enemy over your life in the name of Jesus. I come against these lies, these accusations, these perversions of truth in the name of the Lord. And I thank you that no weapon formed against me, no weapon formed against you, no weapon formed against anybody listening to this call at any time in the history of the world, whenever you find it, no weapon of accusation will prosper against you. And I thank you, Lord, for vindication, that vindication will come in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that vindication is our portion, that you are our vindicator, and you will vindicate us in due time. And we will wait upon your vindication, because it belongs to you, and you will execute it speedily on our behalf. I thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, for the seers in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the seers. Thank you, Lord, for the seers. I need some more seers in my prophetic prayer group. Go to pray for Jennifer.com. If you're a seer and you see, now don't send me some stuff, you know, without the good part. Amen. Don't just release fear at me. Don't just release fear at me. Don't release fear at me with doom and gloom. Go see the other side of it. Amen. Hallelujah. All right, love you guys. We're going to go back into worship. I have to get some coffee. I have to take a shower and get some coffee. I did not get up at 4 this morning because I was out until after 11 last night. And we must have our beauty sleep. Amen. We must have our beauty sleep. Yes. We must have our beauty sleep. Amen. So, praise God. We will be back with you Monday, praise God. But Apostle Ryan and I are going to do a Facebook Live later today. And so look for that. Amen. In Jesus' name. I'll be back with you soon. You're gonna finish.